2022 was an exceptional year for space exploration and research. Back in time, the James Webb Space Telescope revolutionized our understanding of the universe. In November, the much-anticipated and long-delayed Artemis 1 started its first and rudimentary mission, re-establishing the era of lunar exploration. DART, the first-ever planetary defense prototype created by NASA, was a tremendous success. This year, for the first time ever, the existence of unidentified flying objects was confirmed by two legitimate firms that launched an investigation into the sightings of these phenomena. We also received incredible images from the Mars rover Perseverance and its helicopter companion Ingenuity, and we learned more than we ever thought possible about exoplanets and distant stars in the galaxy. NASA sponsored a group that initiated a study of what the government termed unexplained aerial occurrences earlier this year. More frequently, UFOs bring together scientists from fields ranging from physics to astrobiology. This squad is distinct from the Pentagon-based examination of unidentified flying objects reported by military aviators and U.S. defense. These concurrent initiatives by NASA and the Pentagon underscore a turning point in the search for exoplanet answers. After decades of avoiding, refuting, and discrediting UFO sightings, major corporations are now investigating these reports. Anomalous sightings, unresolved mysteries of extraterrestrial phenomena date to the 1940s. In 1947, there were widespread reports of unusual objects in the sky from around the world. William Brussel, a New Mexico rancher, awoke to a regular day 75 miles north of Roswell when he made a startling discovery. On the property, he discovered a vast area of bright debris comprised of rubber strips, tinfoil, a rather robust paper, and sticks. Through the collaboration of a local rancher and the Chaves County Sheriff's Office, the Roswell Army Airfield was able to get control of a disc. The group intelligence officer summoned to the incident was Major Jesse A. Marcel, who would later collect the box of debris and deliver it to the higher authorities. On his way, his curiosity overcame him, and he produced a box. The Guardian later claimed that the markings he had discovered resembled hieroglyphics. However, the Army immediately intervened and refuted the narrative, claiming that the wreckage was actually from a downed weather balloon, and Marcel was no longer asked to be photographed with the debris. The matter was thus closed. Since then, decades have passed, tremendous technical development has been made, and humanity now resides in space. The International Orbit Station is the largest structure ever constructed by mankind in space. It is in orbit around the Earth, circling the planet at an incredible rate every 90 minutes. If you know when and where to look, it is highly visible from Earth as a brilliant moving point of light that surpasses the brilliance of Venus. It is a multinational program that provides astronauts and cosmonauts with a home. The ISS has enabled humanity to travel farther into space than ever before. It has essentially provided people with a permanent abode in space, something that was previously considered science fiction. Like most space programs, the International Space Station is evidence of the lengths we will go to in our pursuit of knowledge, as it has enabled humans to maintain a permanent presence in space. Since the arrival of the first crew, humans have been living in space daily. Since then, there have been numerous unexplained sightings of unidentified flying objects near the International Space Station, which have occasionally corresponded with NASA turning down the live stream immediately thereafter. Let's begin with one of the more peculiar sightings when 10 unidentified flying objects were detected on the ISS live stream before it was abruptly shut off. One of NASA's most recent live streams captured footage of up to 10 unexplained flying objects circling the International Space Station. A sharp-eyed space watcher observed the objects and claims the live feed showed the UFOs creating a circle above the southern Atlantic Ocean. The conspiracy theorist arrived at his conclusion after observing the video closely, which shows just black objects passing the camera. The video has been widely disseminated and has sparked numerous speculations and conversations among UFO and space enthusiasts on social media. The initial screenshots depicted all black objects, displaying the startling discovery. The UFO hunters stated, "This is a screen capture from the International Space Station above the South Atlantic at around 8,300 meters, showing 10 unidentified objects traveling with the space station above the Earth." Since then, numerous theorists and UFO hunters have remarked on the photographs and given their own theories. A user stated that there appears to be an abundance of black knight probes. Then something even stranger occurred, when a Russian cosmonaut tweeted about the possibility of UFOs. Ivan Wagner, a Russian astronaut currently stationed on board the International Space Station and orbiting the Earth, claims to have recorded footage of possible UFOs while filming the Southern Lights. "Guests in space, or how I filmed a new time-lapse video," Wagner stated in a tweet containing a video of the clip. The one-minute film depicts the Aurora Australis traveling close to Australia and Antarctica. However, in the video, you will see something other than the Aurora that he wrote. "And this is what caught people's attention. Did this cosmonaut know something? Was he implying something? Or did he simply consume?" The footage depicts the curved edge of the Earth at night, with the green aurora traveling across its surface and multiple stops visible in the distance. At 9 to 12 seconds, five objects are observed flying at the same distance. Wagner asked in a subsequent tweet whether the objects were meteors, satellites, or saurs. He said that the footage was captured using a time-lapse technique. Thus, the quick flash of the objects lasted approximately 52 seconds in actual time. Wagner did not claim to have witnessed the occurrence as it occurred, and no one else on the ISS has confirmed its existence. Neither did he specify when the footage was recorded, regardless of the phenomena. In the video, it does appear as a string of light syringed in a distinct angled line. Wednesday, Roscosmos Vicious Space Agency released the footage via its own Twitter account. "With so many thoughts, incidents, and ideas circulating throughout this decade's conversation, there have been many more occurrences like these aboard the ISS. What do we even believe? We have all heard more than our fair share of UFO sighting claims, whether they involve clouds that resemble spaceships or rogue meteors. Internet users adore alien conspiracy theories. There is no denying that a few UFO encounters are simply too bizarre and have no earthly explanation."